Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me? Well, if the truth be known, I'm a wee tad bit frustrated that I'm doing this type of a demo again. But I have been reading news stories that people's password protocols still suck. Apparently, the worst passwords of 2014 were pretty much the same passwords as people were using in 2013. The number one worst password was, again, 123456. Brilliant if you're using that. Second most popular was the word password as your password, and it goes on and on with poor password management. And here's the challenge that we face. If you've got your accounts and you've got poor passwords, the same password being repeated or a weak password, the challenge that we have is A, almost all of our accounts these days are attached to our email address. That's our account name. So it's very easy to identify us because of that, either that or say our Facebook profile. If we've got a weak password and one of the accounts that we're dealing with gets compromised, then they've got access to not only our password, but also our username, which probably translates into multiple other accounts, meaning they can get access to other information. That alone should scare the pants off you. But when you add to the fact that most breaches occur and the company's not aware that the breach has occurred for weeks or even months until after it's happened, and then they let us know about it, there's going to be a period of maybe several months that people have access to everything about you and you don't know anything about it. That puts you at risk, but it also puts your employer and your friends and family at risk as well, because information coming from you to them, they believe is trusted information coming from a trusted source. They don't realize how poor your password protection is. So consequently, you're putting everybody at risk. It's a huge issue, and it's something that we should do something about. And it's not that difficult to do something about it. I've shown you in the past setting up Lastpass, which is the password manager that I use. It's a little bit difficult to use in some ways for some people. It takes some getting used to. So I discovered recently another password manager, which is kind of in the same vein as LastPass, but maybe a little bit easier to use. It's called Dashlane, and it's also very inexpensive. One thing I like about LastPass is what a bargain it is for the price. So I've installed Dashlane on my system as well, and I'm just going to take you through some of the top-level things to try and get you to understand how effective and easy this is for you to use, and what the benefits might be, and see if we can't get you moving in the direction of one of these or another password manager. So once again today on Dotto Tech, it's password managers. I know I'm starting to sound like a little bit of a grumpy bear because I keep coming back to the same issue. And do I sound crabby as it is? It's because since back to the days of my TV show, I've been harping on effective password management for people. And, well, we know that it's in a lot of cases... I'll just keep on fighting the good fight and hope that people eventually get it. So I've got this new one called Dashlane installed, which I want to show you. Now Dashlane, you can go visit dashlane.com. You see a lot of ads. They've been running a lot of ads for it lately. And it's a nice, simple password manager, but the key to it is it's cross-platform. It'll use the same, we basically can set up the same account and use it on our computers, notebooks, and on our mobile devices, which is essential. Once again, for the most part, you're going to be using it through your browser or through your mobile device. So let me just talk you through the basic setup, because setting it up, I think this is where a lot of people stop and they don't kind of move ahead, is they're kind of afraid to do that first click and kind of get on the process. The process for setting it up, and you can start with a free account. You can upgrade to premium at any point. And the premium service costs $40 a year in this case. It's a little bit more than what I pay for LastPass, but still, you know, really reasonable dollars, especially when you consider what some of the other password managers cost. So for the free version, you get the password manager, which is a piece of software that installs on your desktop, but also there are extensions that install in all your browsers because that's where you use it the most. You've got an autofill feature, a nice digital wallet, which really should help you in the e-commerce world, storing your credit cards and making it more convenient. And it works on all the platforms. What you don't get is mainly you don't get sync across your platforms. This is the big one right here. You don't get a backup, which might be a big deal, but a bigger deal, I think, is the fact that you don't get to sync it with your smartphones, etc. It's really just for the desktop, but it'll give you an idea of how it works. You can play with it, use it for a little bit. You can even install LastPass as well, play with that, and then decide which one you actually want to move into when you move it over to your mobility. One of the cool things about Dashlane, which I really like, is the ability to share passwords. They've got an enterprise or a team version, which might be really useful in the office environment, where you've got access to a client's account for a short period of time or something like that, and you you want to give team members access. If multiple people have Dashlane, you can share account information and share access in a secure environment, which is a pretty cool way of using it. It's also really useful for, you know, say, give it, if you're traveling abroad and you want to give a family member access to your bank account while you're gone, you can do it through Dashlane, so you're not sending out the account information in the public, in email or over multiple emails or something like that. So those are the basic differences between the apps. Now, when you install it, or between the versions, when you install it, the process is quite simple. On the Mac version, what I did was I downloaded an app, and this is the app here which I installed. As I went to install the app, the first thing they asked me to set up is a master password. So you have to create one really good password that you have to remember, and that master password then controls all of the other passwords. It keeps them encrypted and kind of behind a firewall. So you have to keep keep track of your master password. It has to be at least 8 digits long. It has to have capital letters as well as numbers. So make that a really robust and good and as cryptic a password as is possible. Once you set that up, then they will go through your computer and they'll look on your browser for any passwords and accounts that happen to be have been embedded already in your browser. Because, you know, as you're going through your day-to-day activities, sometimes your browser is saving password and account information. So it strips all of that out of your browsers and allows you to set those up as kind of your first, as your starter set of accounts. So that's what I did. For the most part, for me, they're really old accounts that I really never use anymore because I've moved everything over into LastPass, but it does give us a base to work from for this demonstration. Then they ask for permission to install the browser extension. For the most part, you're going to be using Dashlane in your browser. So I've got it here running. I'm running in Chrome right here, and you can see the browser extension right here in the corner. Actually, LastPass works the exact same. Most password managers are going to install as an extension. This recognizes that I have Firefox, Chrome, and Safari installed in all of them, and it'll sync across all of those at the same time. The syncing that's in the premium version is syncing across devices, not syncing within the same computer, if that makes sense to you. So once that's done, it's pretty straightforward. Here is the accounts that it's found for me, and it's kind of set up. So it goes through and allows us to manage our accounts in this kind of environment, in this browser environment. But the thing that I find really useful is the fact that we can go into the security dashboard as soon as we've set it up, and it tells us what your security score is. Now, mine's very low, but these, as I say, these are old accounts that I'm not really using anymore. But it's looking through, and it's found that I have, out of 25 accounts that it imported, it found 18 of them have weak passwords. And it have 14 of them have duplicated passwords. So that's what we want to go through and clean up. And it'll actually allow us to begin that process right here from this panel of clicking on replacing passwords, going through and updating all of the passwords. You don't have to make up a bunch of passwords. It'll automatically create cryptic passwords for each. You just have to remember that master password. Now, when you go and visit any secure site, and you want to sign into any of your accounts, there's a couple of ways that you can go about it with Dashlane. You can click here on in the browser window on the tool in the toolbar, and it'll pop up all of the different websites that you have passwords for, and you can navigate to them just by clicking on the icon there, and it brings you in and logs you in to that account that easily. It's very slick and I really like this. This is really nice and intuitive. It's almost like a bookmarking service that they've got here. Conversely, in LastPass, which is the password manager I've used up to now, you have to go in and you have to start typing in each of the sites. Basically, in this, you can see that their menu is a little more utilitarian. It might be a little more powerful in some ways, but a little less user-friendly. So you get the idea of the difference between the two apps just from that one thing that we looked at there. But that's basically the process that you go through. And then if you are signing in on any account, let me just go to an account that I might have to sign in. Well, let me sign out of my Google account, and then I'll show you what happens. Oh, no, I'll just go to WordPress. I'll go to a WordPress site. There we go. I'll go to sign into WordPress. And as I go there, what'll happen is, do you see what's happened here is Dashlane has brought up all of the different WordPress accounts that I have and has given me access to be able to log in as soon as it recognizes that I'm at one of them. So it'll allow me to log in. So we've got this functionality here. You also typically, if you take a look inside of the dialog box itself, you'll be able to click on there. If you just have a single one, you'll be able to click on it and it will bring up the passwords for that particular site itself. Now, in this case here, it's actually showing me the LastPass ones because LastPass is installed and just confusing things a little bit. But basically, you can just click in any dialog box as you go to enter. Now, some of the other features that it'll do is it also looks for autofill. So you also put in all of your different basic information, your name, your birthday, your address, and it will look to autofill and auto-populate that information for you with your permission with each site that you visit, which is a big benefit. And we'll also do the same kind of things with your payment system if you want to store credit cards for making online payments a little bit easier. And if you trust the system for that, it will work very well in that area. The final thing I wanted to show you before I leave it is the sharing center, which allows you to take, and if you have somebody else that you want to share a password with that has Dashlane and is in your community, you can share an item with them, you can share an email with them, which will send them an email that looks just like this. Let me go to my updates here, and there it is right there. And they send you an email that includes a password, and so that it, even, the password's not out in the open, but basically you've got an HTML or a web link which you can click on, which will then launch the app to give them access to an app, which is great if you're a services company and you need to give somebody access to your Facebook page for a short period of time or something like that. You could get them to sign in if you want through this sort of a secure environment where you control the access for a period of time. That's one of the really nice features of Dashlane. They've kind of thought through that team environment quite well. Bottom line is, I don't care whether you use LastPass, whether you use a tool like 1Password, whether you use KeePass, whether you use Dashlane, find one that resonates for you, that you think you can figure out and you can use, and start to use it. It's only step one in the security process. You should also do 2-factor authentication, which we have a video on, which you should be watching and taking advantage of. That's a really good way to really up your level of personal security, but this is the first step. Good username and good password management. I think Dashlane, I'm giving it a big thumbs up. I really like the interface. I'm not sure I'm going to switch over from LastPass because I'm used to using LastPass and I've had it for so long. But if I was starting out, I would not hesitate making my first step being the first step onto Dashlane. I think it's an awesome, awesome introduction. I hope you found this video today to be useful. Remember, there's 3 ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. First is, please subscribe to this channel. Second, subscribe to our newsletter, and then you'll hear about all of our live events coming up. And third, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We're supported by you, the people who view these videos. If you want to find out what supporting Dotto Tech entails and what the benefits are, because there are benefits such as free access to our awesome courses, then drop by our Patreon page and have a look at what Dotto Tech patronage is all about. Regardless of which way, please stay in touch. I look forward to seeing you again in the near future. I'm Steve Dotto. Till next time, have fun storming a castle.